autism stats are horrific. More and more families find their bundle of joy turning into a bundle of terror as they face the heartache of raising a little one that doesn't really fit into the world. The trouble begins with a wiring problem, which leads to imbalances in serotonin. The autistic individual ends up with too little serotonin in the brain and too much everywhere else. Since brain serotonin runs the socializing networks, this shortage creates shortfalls in the ability to interact with others. Although the problem only manifests when children are old enough to be attentive to others, the wiring defect is something that happens in the womb. Serotonin is a morphogen. It helps shape the brain. Adequate levels of serotonin must be present during the brain's development to ensure everything is wired correctly. Genetics definitely contributes to the crossed wiring, but something about the environment in which the baby is developing is underwriting the genes, ultimately interfering with the normal wiring process. In autism, lots of somethings have been implicated. Inflammation, antibodies, too little thyroid, too little vitamin D. In this episode of Better Body Chemistry TV, we explore how too little vitamin D contributes to bad serotonin wiring. Better Body Chemistry TV is brought to you by Dr. Sandy, a scientist turned gremlin buster, helping you battle sugar gremlins, heffalumps, and other health horribles through better body chemistry. Remember, small things can make a big difference to your health. Now, to make serotonin, the body begins with a chemical called tryptophan. Your body gets this tryptophan from the foods you eat, especially foods that are protein. An enzyme known as tryptophan hydroxylase enzyme begins the process of whipping up a batch of serotonin. TPH mixes tryptophan, iron, and tetrahydrobiopterin in the mixing bowl to create hydroxylated tryptophan, which ultimately becomes serotonin. Both your body and your brain need a supply of serotonin. Unfortunately, the serotonin produced by the body cannot be used by the brain because it's not able to get through the brain security system, the blood-brain barrier. To solve this dilemma, you have two different TPH enzymes to make the serotonin you need. The enzyme which produces serotonin in the body is called TPH1. The enzyme doing the cooking in the brain is referred to as TPH2. Although they both know how to make hydroxylated tryptophan, they run their kitchens a little differently, and this ends up being important. The brain, TPH, gets cooking when vitamin D pops into the kitchen. The body, TPH, on the other hand, stops cooking when vitamin B pops into the kitchen. He's fascinated by surfing, so he ends up chatting to vitamin D instead of getting on with the cooking. So when vitamin D is around, lots of serotonin is produced in the brain, but very little is made in the rest of your body. When vitamin D is not around, production of serotonin in the brain grinds to a stop, but a lot of serotonin is produced in the body, where it can get up to mischief, causing inflammation. Serotonin problems may thus begin with vitamin D shortages. Stats suggest lots and lots of people are short of vitamin D. The primary reason? Getting adequate amounts of vitamin D requires regularly spending a little time in the sun. Foods are not really designed to provide you with vitamin D. Unfortunately, modern living is indoor living. We work indoors, we play indoors, we even travel indoors. On the rare occasion we do venture outdoors, we often take special precautions to cover up, layering on sunblock to ensure that we are protected from the sun. Adequate levels of vitamin D are needed to produce serotonin in the brain. So everyone should dose up on vitamin D, but it is especially important for moms to be to dose up. The vitamin D will help keep serotonin production on track, shaping how your baby's brain develops. Now, the best way to dose up is through sun exposure. It takes 10 to 20 minutes or so of sun a few times a week to get all you need. A few minutes in the sun will not turn you into a crispy. So no need to worry about skin cancer. And best of all, it's free. If spending a little time in the sun is impossible, then you should consider purchasing a vitamin D supplement as your plan B. Serotonin metabolism is wonky in autism. This research confirms vitamin D is something that matters during pregnancy. Make sure your baby's brain has everything it needs to wire up the socializing system. Go suntan your bum. Looking for more ways to create better body chemistry for your family? Visit www.betterbodychemistry.com. Browse our library. Sign up for one of our free e-courses. The advice is simple to follow and based on real science, not hype. Know someone who's expecting? Help her decrease her risk of bringing home a baby with a wiring problem by sharing this video and subscribe to our channel so you can discover more strategies to optimize your health and the health of your family. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time on Better Body Chemistry TV. Remember, small things can make a big difference to your health.